Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Carla Gallardi, and I'm the owner of Debonair Dogos in San Diego, California. We've been breeding Dogos for over 21 years, and first and foremost, they're not for everybody. You have to be very strong-willed to have a Dogo. You have to know what you're doing to have a Dogo. I don't like when I get people that call me and they're like, well, I've got, you know, three triplets at home that are toddlers, and you know, five wiener dogs and two cats and a raccoon. You know, a Dogo would be great for me. A Dogo is not going to be great for you. You know, maybe later on in life, a Dogo would be great for you. Because we're seeing too many go in shelters now, and you know, that's not fair to the breed. The breed's supposed to be rare, and that's, you know, for a reason. We're at the International All Breed Show in Claremont, California. Dog shows were actually started by hunters to go over their breeding stock.
That is true.
So to say, you know, I'm a macho hunter, I don't need to show my dog. You need to know what your dog's conformation is if you want him to succeed and live a long life, you know, and be structurally sound to hunt. You know, I don't like when some hunters will say, oh, I don't have to get the OFA health testing either because my dog can jump in and out of the truck and hunt all day. You don't know what's inside the dog. In conformation, you know, you're paying the judge to evaluate your dog, good or bad. You know, they can tell you, you know, things that you could work on for your next generations. So it's really important to get out there and show your dog, and we really wish we had more, you know, Dogos in competition. With AKC, we're getting more and more Dogos coming out, so that's a good thing. This registry gives you written critiques. It's more like an FCI show, and they do bring in judges from other countries. So today we have two judges from Japan that are FCI judges. We also have AKC judges here today. And so yeah, you can get an international title as well without having to travel internationally. And this show, they go by the FCI standard. And so they give you a written critique, which I can show you after. That the judge will make comments about like the ear crop, if it's set right, if it's cropped correctly. The eye color, the Dogo's eye should be a dark brown. They should have full pigmentation on their nose. Dogos do get pigmentation on their eyes and on their lips as well, but that comes with age. Toro's 5 and a half, so he has a lot of pigment. But basically they just judge the dog's conformation, but they give you a critique and tell you the why, where AKC, you're allowed 2 minutes to show your dog to the judge, and you know, they check the bite and they go over the dog, but you never know why they might have picked the other dog and not yours. You don't know, you know, what the judge was thinking, your dog's flaws, which here, you know, they could say what his flaws are, and then I could be like, oh, okay, well, the next female I breed him to, you know, I'll make sure, you know, that we're looking to improve that. Yep, we show AKC and UKC. We also show FCI. We've gone down to Mexico and shown down there as well. Okay, my husband's family has Dogos, and we got our first in 2001. And this is Toro de Debonair, and he's our 8th generation on one side and 7th on the other. They're naturally courageous. They're loyal to a T. They love their family. They overlove their family. And they're still protective. They're wary of strangers. So it's not your dog's not everyone's dog. You know, he's your dog. They kind of blend to what you do. So, I mean, our dogs are basically just hand walked. We've got a good sized yard that they, you know, play and wear themselves out in. But we do some barn hunt, which is where they're timed and they have to find a rat. like in bales of straw. So we do barn hunt with them. We have done some pen testing and some, you know, practice hunting with them, but obviously they're city dogs. So, you know, in California, we have to travel all the way to Texas if you want to do any hunting. But basically just walking and, you know, going to dog shows. We might try dock diving, but I'm not sure how they'll do. And I know other breeders have started doing the B-cats, which is like a fast cat where they are timed running. Toro is actually 25 and a quarter inches, which is AKC, what they kind of like the male Dogos to be in AKC. Toro is right around 100 pounds. So, you know, he's more lower, stockier. He's got good bone. Let's see what else about you. Toro's been shown in AKC. He's an AKC champion. He finished the first year the Dogos were allowed to show AKC. Before that, he did UKC. He's a UKC grand champion. He's also an international champion through International All Breed. So this weekend, he's going for his national championship with them. He's my daughter's dog, and she's actually, that's the first litter of Dogos that she was the breeder of. So my daughter's 23, and she's had Dogos since she was 2 years old. And so he's her ideal Dogo. And he goes to marching band. She does marching band in San Diego State University, and Toro sometimes goes with her. And but yeah, he's a good all-around dog. That's one thing that I probably don't like about the Dogos as much, is they always have to be touching you, laying on you, getting their white fur all over you. Yeah, that's one thing about the breed, that they're a close talker. They always have to be like right on you. Yeah, if you have any more questions, you can you know, shoot me a message on my Instagram at San Diego Dogos. We're Debonair Dogos in San Diego. My phone number is right there on my Instagram. Give me a call.